Good evening, everybody. It's good to see you. I have some announcements. If you'd like to join us on retreat, please sign up soon. The retreat starts Friday. And I'd love to have you. I'd love to have you. Because so many of you here this evening are coming to the retreat, I thought I'd just speak about it just for a couple minutes. So a couple days before a retreat, or sometimes a week before, you may begin to notice the energies of the retreat container. Energies of grace of the Holy Spirit. And so if you're sensitive like me, you might start to notice these energies trickling into you. And of course, if we are unconscious and just running around and being lost in our own egoic identification, you won't notice this. And so I just want to acknowledge, you know, what's been happening the last couple of days. That these new energies, new forces have been coming down. And they are here for you. Literally for you. So this is God, life, showing up for you. And I encourage you to become more consciously aware of this, to give yourself permission to slow down a little bit and to step into a meditator's mind, witness, observe, be awake to what's here. So the second thing I'd like to share, excuse me, that oftentimes on the path, if you commit to something, for example, a retreat, you say, I'm going to take a couple days off and unhook from life. Oftentimes, the habitual nature of life will come forward and challenge you. And so it's very common right before a retreat for, you know, a little mini drama to unfold in your life. And, you know, some of you may smile because you know this dance. Maybe it's already come in a challenge. So maybe the boss says, hey, I need you really to be here on Friday, you know, when you took off Friday. Maybe one of your children knows wanting more of your time or attention, or, you know, driving you a little bit bonkers. Sometimes the car breaks. Sometimes we have an old bout of anger or sadness or grief come forward, a feeling of depression. And so anytime there's more light that's coming into the room, the forces of resistance, of habit, they naturally come forward into the light and they're seen. And sometimes they make a little, you know, throw a little fit. And that's okay. That's okay. That's normal. And so can you take the backward step and choose to be here now? Choose to walk forward on the path, despite the challenge. And so anyways, I invite you, and just beginning to have the attitude that everything is divine, everything is God. The retreat has started. My spiritual life has started. I am here on this path. So if you haven't already, you can close your eyes. breathe deep into your belly, into your hara. And acknowledge this, acknowledge your commitment. I am here, walking forward on my spiritual path. I am here, consciously choosing to connect with the goodness of my own heart. And so just breathing in and breathing out. I am here in this moment, choosing actively, consciously to unhook from my busy mind, my messy emotional nature. And so we're stepping into our quiet strength, our power, our autonomy. My consciousness is alert, awake. My heart is open. I am rooted here. In the quiet presence of my being. So I invite you just to take a couple of minutes here, just breathing in and breathing out, inviting the body to relax, to be comfortable. Inviting a great collective exhale, great collective letting go throughout the entirety of the body. We're breathing in and breathing out. Letting the ego relax, let go of its job. In the most gentle way, giving ourselves permission to be held by the earth. Just to be held. By the quiet, nurturing love of the earth. Gently scanning your body. Am I relaxed? In my forehead? In my cheeks, my jaw? The back of the skull? Am I relaxed? So softening, softening, softening. Just gently noticing the spaciousness of your mind. So breathing in, breathing out. Acknowledging this space. This gentle, vast emptiness. Just giving your ego permission, your human self permission to melt. To melt into the emptiness, to unwind, unravel, untangle. So softening the throat, the neck, the shoulders. Behind the heart. The whole upper back just melting, taking your load off. The middle back just relaxing. Softening. Softening in the chest, the ribs. Inviting the body to be held by the earth. Quiet support holding you from below. Trusting the love and the nurturing support of Mother Earth. Giving yourself permission to melt more and more fully to this quiet, dark, vast emptiness and luminosity. So more and more as you soften, surrender, Let go throughout the entirety of the body. You may notice this vast, empty darkness beginning to become radiant with light, luminous. You may notice this tingling light. Giving birth to itself out of the darkness, bringing forth a vast, empty, radiant luminosity. Awakening a non-dual realm. It's quite different than the consciousness of ego, of separation. So breathing in and breathing out. So are you here? Have you joined me? Or are you lost? The silliness of the drama, the pain of the mind. You don't have to solve your human problems now. Let God hold you, all of you, your brilliance, your beauty, and your pain and confusion. Let God solve your life. Let God do the healing. Your job is to surrender, to melt. To merge with what's here. So breathing in and out. Feeling a supreme tenderness in the heart. Bursting with light. For some of you in this room, there may be a feeling in the heart. I can't do this. I can't do this life. I can't heal myself. I failed here and there, and all of that's okay. It's all welcome. Maybe a feeling of suffering or hurting. Bring it forward. Give it all to God. Rest it in her lap. Say, Lord, you made this world. You made my difficulty. You fix it. I surrender it at your feet. So breathing in, breathing out. Letting go a little more fully. Your solar plexus, your heart, your emotional nature. Surrendering your will. Lord, you live. Shine your grace in me, through me, as me. I bow and surrender. You fix this world, my life. Lift me up to the higher realms of divinity and holiness. You soften, open, and receive what's here. Letting go a little more fully, deep in the belly. See if you can let go of that tension below the belly button. Letting go deep in the pelvis. Pelvic floor, the inner thighs, let go of any primordial or unconscious tension. You don't have to carry that any longer. Do you trust that it's okay to open and receive a greater way? Again, if there's any entanglement in the mind, to step away, find awareness to drop deep into the body. Anytime you get lost, come back to the central channel. Feel, experience the power, the strength, the luminosity. Of the indwelling Christ. You may notice the energy is getting quite intense. Can you soften? Trust. Receive what's here. Get out of your head. Come down deep, deep into the body. Breathing, feeling, opening. Experiencing this luminosity as your very nature. Again, just checking in with the belly. Has it tensed up again? And if so, you breathe, feel open, and surrender. Shine your light into us, Lord. Awaken us to a fuller way of being. If your mind is alert, awake, and your heart is open, you may notice a shift in the energies, greater brilliance coming forward, perhaps some heat. Again, sometimes resistance comes forward, and that's okay, that's normal. We don't fight with resistance. Rather, lay it at the feet of the Divine Mother. Surrender, surrender, surrender. Open, open, open. Receive this heavenly gift. Just here to awaken you. Out of the small, limited sense of self. Into something much, much greater. Breathing in and breathing out. Welcoming a greater consciousness. Inviting any and all resistance or darkness, confusion, pain to burn up in this light. Be held, embraced, transformed, released, so we no longer have to be trapped by that which is limited. Feeling, opening, experiencing this greater light. Freedom giving birth in you. Crown chakra is open and receptive. Feeling this light in the third eye. Relaxing and opening the throat. Finding this Christ-like radiance to awaken and flow through your being. And down through the crown, the third eye, the throat, into the heart. Ascending into the solar plexus, the hara, the pelvis. Feeling the quiet strength of the earth just holding you, supporting you. Are you open to this profoundly transformative process, experience? So for some of you, this light, this grace comes so intensely, you may feel it almost coming with a great pressure, like it's crushing you. And if that's you, just breathe and feel open, smile. We're letting go unto God, not unto death, but unto God. So welcome. Welcome what's here. Seeing this light penetrating your being, flowing all the way down through you into the earth itself. Inviting the holiness of the earth to come forward. This quiet strength and power. So your consciousness is merging with the consciousness of heaven. Merging the foundational strength and power of the earth. So with this intensity, it can become a little bit disoriented in your experience. That's okay. Just breathe, feel, open, trust. Trust what's here. Do not fight any of it, just soften. Trust. You are absolutely loved. Absolutely adored by God. Let this grace enter you fully. Let any darkness, pain, confusion be cast out of you. feeling opening, receiving this great light, this profound strength. Can you allow yourself not to be a small, limited, egoic being? But rather the fullness of heaven, the fullness of earth. In you as you. Again, checking in with the solar plexus, the belly. Letting go, letting go, letting go. Melting, merging, opening. Letting all the walls crack. This consciousness bursting open. Can you be bright, huge, vast, wide, empty, full, luminous, radiant? radiant divinity. Shining out in all directions. Lord, make me a conduit for thy peace, thy light, love, healing. May your grace shine through me. As in the entirety of this realm. May all beings, without exception, be flooded with this light, this love, this freedom. And so, a deep bow of respect to each and every one of you. So much love from my heart to yours. Good night, everyone. Nice to be with you. Bye for now.